What's up, guys? Welcome to this flight from St. Kitts to Saint-Ouen using the Cessna C-172 from A2A, and we'll be taking off from runway 07. We should be taking off from runway 07, right? Landing at runway 08. I'm just setting up this flight plan through PFBX. Let me get it exported real quick. So let's go to aircraft database, select my Cessna 172, and hit random payload. As a matter of fact, we're gonna go maximum payload. Nah, let's go random payload, maximum amount of fuel, find destination alternates. Let's PFBX do its thing. Take off alternates. Point of no return, this should be Tango India Sierra X-ray. That's the Henry E. Wilson. US Virgin Islands. Right. So hit find route. That should be our route today. Compute. It's gonna tell me this fuel stuff, so. Cargo, we'll put 0 for cargo. We'll just hit compute flight. We don't have any extra cargo, we have baggage. So let's go hit release. Let me just send this to VATSIM real quick. We take a look at the aircraft for the time being. Prefile the flight plan, get back to PFBX, export, save routes. Let's just get rid of that, back to schedule and official flight plan. Right. Let's check the weather information here. Think it's a nearest, think it's, let's go. We got 090 at 30 knots, broken at 1700, QNH 1015, temperature 30, and we should be good until actually until 1850. So these are the forecasts for we have vicinity shows in the vicinity and stuff like that. Okay, so let's just get to the flight plan now. We'll be taking off, releasing with 220 pounds of fuel, zero fuel rate of 2231, max planned takeoff rate 2431. So let's just get right to the sim. A matter of fact, before I do that, yeah, let's just get right to the sim. All right, one thing I like to do is actually walk around the aircraft for a while. So let's get walking. Just get the control up and running. Quiet day in St. Kitts right now. So you see, we got the aircraft tied down, properly tied down. Pilot covers and everything, wheel jack set. Hang on for 1 second. Alright, so that's basically it. Aircraft looks in good condition. We're gonna check with the garage and the maintenance guys. Wow, I'm getting dizzy. Alright, so we're back in the aircraft. Let's just bring up the pilot's note. So cabin is warm, but it's 30 degrees outside. Controls, we have control lock set, wheel chuck set, tie down set, doors left and right open, pilot covers on. So we'll be pushing back, not pushing back, oh God, this is not a jet. We'll be releasing 220, so let's put 210 on this side, which is 42%. And another 42% here. Actually, nah. Carry it up to 220, they say 220. So that's 76 on one side. Let's try to balance out this. Looks fairly well, yeah. Go back to PFPS. Let's see, we have PAX 3. So let's put. We have a nice female here today. Riding shotgun. To balance out the aircraft in like a X motion, we'll have another female here. So we have total weight 23, 24. Back to PFPX. So we can actually take another guy. We can actually take another passenger, but let's just keep it at that. Because total weight is saying 23, 24. 23, 31. That's okay. Alright, that's basically it. Let me check the garage. Aircraft is in excellent shape. All checks all right. Yeah. Everything seems to be good. Alright, so let's just remove the ties around the aircraft. Control lock off. Wheel chucks set because the parking brakes is set. Pilot covers come off. You can now close your right doors. And the left one. Let's get some battery power. First, I like to hit the nav switch on. So when I power up the battery, you have nav light set so that people around the aircraft would know that hey, this aircraft actually has power inside it right now. So be careful. So battery checks are good. We got power. That's the avionics checked. Good tone, good tone. Transponder set off. Now, since the cabin is warm, I don't have the primary fuel, so that's okay. However, I'll set this to maximum fuel mixture and set this to quarter, which is 25. 25, yeah. Bump it to maybe 30. Yeah, 30 could work. Yeah, 30. Oh, fuel pumps being used today. Alright, so you can yell outside the left window, clear, and then so the aircraft up and running. You can get this flight plan running real quick from Hubble. We'll be flying on VATSIM, so let's just get VATSIM network up and running. Alright, so VATSIM network is up and running. Set up my flight plan. We'll be taking flight level 1,000, which will be converted back to 10,000 feet once we're in Sangwan ESPs. So let's go to modify. Your seven taking off keeper one using the TCAL transition. Let's get rid of this final altitude point. We'll be using 1 with 8 as PFPX told us. 1 with 8 for Oh, take off. That's when there was the attack, and you could actually hear them, I think. Yeah, they're just loud ass people. Charcoal tree coming in from Gabar. ILS 1v8. That should set us in right nice. So we hit done, activate. Bam, just like that. Should have. Set in a minute. And there we go. Let's get back to the ground. At sink it's will be coming from Bravo 1. Keep stand Bravo 1 back in space Bravo 1 using runway 07 and Alpha for taxi. Alpha Bravo. We'll be taking off from that intersection Bravo. Entering the runway from Bravo actually. Alright, so let's go back to the aircraft. Alright, so we'll not be using VFR squawk code, so let's hit this on. Take it from out. We'll be squawking it. Yeah, squawking it. You can see in the GPS system right here, I actually have the GPS up and running. Let me just set this to. Was 5 miles, about 10. So I can see which aircraft are coming in. Make sure we are on GPS instead of nav. So time to taxi. Taxi lights coming on. Let's tell my passengers to strap the hell up. So you see, say PAX did not touch anything. Need the effing manual pilot. Alright, let's go. Ready? Off. Let me just set my flaps to full position. Take it off the runway. It actually helps to keep the aircraft pointing to the ground as much as possible. Hang on. One thing I needed to check was. Fixed compass right here, which is saying halfway between closer to okay, 306 near amount, and this is not saying 306, so we have to change this to 306. Give me a moment, 306. 306. Okay, we got to head and select. Let's set the wrong heading. Alright, good to go. Taxi nice and smooth. Set this to degrees Celsius. Alright, there we go, just about 29:30. Yeah, set this to UTC time 15:03. Good to go. Bye, sink it. Let me just slow up for this run my engine procedures. So landing lights coming on. Oh wow, my beacon lights was not on. Strobe lights going on. The cabin is still warm, so let me just get some cool here. To the right neck. The frost is going on. Can I heat off for the moment since the cabin is warm? I'll be switching this to flaps then. Side window that collapsed in, yeah. I'm still pretty good. This is the both channels. Let me try to be cinematic about it. He just missed the center of the oil later. Alright, so mixture set to rich, full 100%. Flaps check. Check. And we can see the door. This is gonna be somewhat of a land departure procedure for the Cessna. This was a jet ATR, maybe like dash 8. This departure procedure will be something like 36. Take a look at the check effect right here. See that we actually just about to hit our first waypoint from the runway. Speed of about 1.15 15 knots. You said in the beginning that there were shores in the city, so the challenge begins. You see, you prefer actually reacting to the real world. This is it, man. You need to get out of this. Just gotta go this back to this evening. Let's see how well the autopilot can do, of course. Should be very manual. As you see. Ladies and gentlemen, we are experiencing some light jumps. Just like, you want a light jump, eh? What the hell? Alright, switching to manual. My ear guard. So you actually handle it much better when you actually this should be like a turn back to the airport situation, but we actually get past their own too. Alright, manual. See, it's a website. Alright, you can see the outgraph. Like, this is now actually describing at almost 1,500 feet per minute, including these trembling engines. Oh my god! What the hell? This wind is crazy, yo. Shit. Actually see some Cleopatra sky up ahead, so that's not the reaction of light. The reaction of light is actually this way, on the left side. Sometimes we look at a little of the U up on this, the aircraft light, so to be green, some sort of meditation. Thank you. hill. Is it not cool? Okay, what I'm actually trying to do is actually fire this indicator right here. Reduce power right now. That's kind of bad. Just in case you actually lose power from this wind. Actually still having the patches in the actually still having the patches in. Switching to autopilot, can't handle this anymore. You see, grandpa just have to task me alone. Wow. Safer to fly this aircraft. Let's see what flaps 1 configuration. First configuration of flaps 10. Flap it. And then catch it back. Alright. Left home. saying right now, this actually extends up to 11,000 feet. We are actually planning to go to, flight level 100, which is 10,000 feet. We got turbulence, gear turbulence actually, so we are racing. We got some steep shear effect. You guys noticed that I haven't actually reached 2,000 feet as yet. This might be it, it might be in the clear. Drift away.
trying to be David Black? This is what we should have done to you, Nick. Okay, we got some fun. Okay. Until the next one. Nice. Okay, it's not so clear. We have that thing over here. But I see like a nice patch of clear ahead. Thank you. closer to the wheel on the right. Asian trainer. Look at the language. Political speed. That you've got. includes the compass and the compass. Hi guys, thank you for watching. I'm back. Thanks for watching, and I will see you at the top of the set. I'm going to set it to the set.